What's up, guys? Onmaths here. We're going to start off with AQA question for handling data. Handling data is quite a broad topic, loads of different types of charts, graphs and stuff in it. And we're going to start off with a bar chart. So in this bar chart, we're asked to draw a bar chart. Wow. Okay. So first things first, we've got to work out our scale. And so looking at this, going upwards, well, the maximum's 5. So what we can do is go up in 1. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And why not just go the full way? Now, always make sure to put the 0 down. And what I tell students who have problems with bar charts is just put a little notch next to each one and just show where the number is. Well, what some students do is they have the numbers between the lines, and the numbers are always on the line. We've got to label that, and look at our table, which just says number. So we could just write number, but probably a better word is frequency. And frequency just means how many. That should probably move across a little bit. Okay. So next thing, we've got to get our bars in. Now, a bar chart should have gaps between the bars. So I'm just going to kind of draw out where I'm going to put the bars. So I'll put Robin here. And Robin goes up to 2. So I'm going to get my thing. And I'm going to make it go up to 2 like that. Now, what I see some students do is they get their colouring crayons out and they love spending ages drawing these. Just do them all in pencil when you're practicing, because in the real exam, you can only use pencil and pen, and that's it. No colours, unfortunately. So we've got Robin, so we've got to label that. Now, I think the exam does allow you to just write R, but I'm not going to chance it, so I'm just going to label Robin there. Okay, next one is Sparrow, which is 5. So let's mark it out, which will be that one and that one. So we've got to leave a space. And I said 5s. Let's put it up to 5. There we go. And it's Sparrow. Looks good to me. Okay, let's mark the next one out. And it's 3. There we go, and it's Wren. And there we go. Right, next one will be a lark at 1. So let's mark that out. So that'll be there. And that will go up to 1. Okay. So we've got those labelled. I should really label my x-axis. So like bird type or just bird is absolutely fine. And I mean, because it's me, I should probably draw the axes as well. No idea whether that's worth a mark. But important things to highlight really is that the bars are all the same width. If you look, they're all one across, and that's really important because you'll lose marks if that's not the case. Your spaces between each one need to all be the same, so they need to be equally spaced. So I've left a gap of 1 between each bar. I think on this exam, if you put the bars together, if you didn't leave any spaces, you would still get full marks. But I always say with a bar chart, always leave spaces. Frequency started at 0. Sometimes students start it at 1 or a different number. Unless you're planning to leave, unless they're all like 106 and 107, where what you do is you put 0 at the bottom, then you do a little squiggle like this to say that you've missed some numbers out, and then the next one up can be 100. But for this one, we're not having to miss any out because they're all quite low numbers. And just make sure you label your x and y axis, and make sure you label all your bars. And also make sure the bars are, or make sure the labels are between the bars. So if you see here, the robin is between the bars there, sparrow is between the bars there. And I could probably tidy that up a bit and sort of shift this across and make it more obvious, because these did migrate, only because unfortunately I can't turn this machine sideways, so I've had to kind of bend awkwardly to try and write them in. So yeah, it should be nice, easy marks. I mean, it's question 6 on the paper, so it's kind of set you up well with 3 marks for the rest of the paper. Next up, Edexcel bring us a beautiful two-way table question. I quite like two-way tables. They're kind of like puzzles you find in newspapers, where you've got to kind of investigate your way around and find the missing numbers. It's like a Sudoku puzzle or something like that. That's just me. However, you'll need to know this to pass your GCSE, which is probably why you're doing these puzzles. So we just go through the information in the description one by one and fill it into the table. It's as simple as that. So the first thing I'm going to notice is, actually we can say that this bit here, 45 rabbits. So 45 rabbits means that the total of everything is going to be 45. And that's a nice way to get started. The next one, 30 rabbits are male. So in total, 30 are male. So 30 are going to be male. The next part, it says 8 of the female rabbits have short hair. So of the female rabbits, 8 have short hair. So this one here is female rabbits that have short hair. It says 8 in there. Next part says 12 of the rabbits with long hair are male. So long hair, and 12 of them are male. Okay, so that's all that's given to us so far. But we can actually work out the rest. So the first thing is the male with short hair. So there's 12 with long hair. There's 30 in total. So if we just do 30 take away 12, we get 18. That's easy to fill out. Then if there's 18 short hair males and 8 short hair females, then in total there will be 26. Okay, if in total there are 26 short hair and the full total rabbits is 45, do 45 take away 26 and we get 19 for the long haired. And if there's 19 long haired in total, 12 of them are male, obviously 7 are going to be female. And if there's 7 female long haired and 8 female short haired, there's going to be 15 female in total. And then we can check that by looking up the male in total is 30, female in total is 15, 30 plus 15 is 45. So we know we've got it right. And always kind of, if you've got time at the end of the exam, always just go through these numbers and check. So it's so easy to make a mistake with these, even though it is a... Well, it's a non-calculator paper. I was going to say, even if it's a calculator paper, just double-check them. Right, its next question says, one of Emma's rabbits is chosen at random. Work out the properties. Rabbit is female with short hair. So, female with short hair, there's 8 of them. So it's 8 over. And this is the total amount of rabbits. So the total amount of rabbits is 45. So that's how you make the probability. Find the one you're looking for, which is female with short hair, which there's 8 of them, over the total amount, which would be 45. Last up will be our OCR offering, and this will be pie chart this time. And so we've hit the main charts and graphs and whatnot of the topic. So this first one says, find the ratio number of employees who cycle to work compared to the number of employees who walk. So we do a basic ratio first. So cycle is 72 and walk is 48. And then we've got cancel them. So we put our lines in. And what we're going to do is just try and cancel it down. So first thing we're going to do, because they're both even, we're just going to divide them by 2. So we've got, 36, and we've got 24, can divide them by 2 again. So that will give us, what, 18 to 12. And we can divide them by 2 again. I'm running out of space here. That's okay. So we've got 9 to 6. And I'm just going to copy that up here so we can finish it off nicely. And lastly, they're both in the 3 times table, so we can divide them both by 3. So that'll be 3 to 2. So let's write that in as our answer. So 3 to 2. Now, I think for this one, they would accept anything like, I don't know, 1.5 to 1 or 1 to 2/3. Because there's a kind of push at the moment that the simplest way of writing ratios is as a unit ratio, so one of them being 1. But I would find it very unusual if a student had written that. Whenever you're simplifying, you're always told that you can't have fractions or decimals in your answer. So I'd stick with that logic. Right, so the next one says 80 employees travel by car. So let's just focus on the car. So car is 240. Degrees, and it says 80 employees travel to work by car, and let's just write that in, and please feel free to annotate the exam. Work out the number of employees who cycle. What colour do we use for cycle? Okay, so cycle is 72 degrees, so that's 72 degrees to work. And the number of employees who walk to work. So let's have a look at walk. So walk is 48 degrees. Let me just write these all in so we know what we're talking about. Okay. So the first thing to realise is that a pie chart just shows proportions, not amounts. So that 240 degrees, it's not giving you an amount, it's just saying out of 360 degrees, 240 degrees were car. So that could be in millions, it could be tens. In fact, in this case, it says 80. So 240 is equivalent to 80. So what we want to start doing is figuring out, okay, so if 240 degrees means 80, how many degrees is each person? So we get that 240 degrees. We divide it by the 80 people that it represents. And what we can divide the top and bottom by 10. This is on the NuN calculator, so I've got to do this without a calculator. 24 divided by 8 is going to be 3. So every one person is equal to 3 degrees. So what we now need to do is we need to divide each of the other angles by 3. Because if one person 3 degrees, then 72 degrees is going to be, was it 24? And if you don't know that, you can do a quick bus stop. So 3 goes on the outside, 72. 3's into 7 go twice, carry the 1. 3's into 12 go 4. So that's 24. And that is cycle. And to do walk, we do the same thing. But it's 48 degrees. And for each one of those degrees, or for each 3 of those degrees, is one person. So we divide it by 3, and that's 16. Again, if you need to do a quick bus stop, 3 into 4 go once, carry the 1. 3 into 6, 16. There we are. So cycle is going to be 24 people. And walk is going to be 16 people. And that is going to do it for today. There's plenty more different topics in handling data. These were kind of the main three that you should definitely know to be able to do the foundation paper. I apologise, I've just realised the title has completely extended the left-hand border. That's annoying, can't change that now, but So do we. maybe I'll try and look at it for next time. Talking about next time, we do these videos every single weekday, Monday to Friday. So if you like this video, click like. But if you want to see more from us, if you want to keep up to date with these and get yourselves ready for the year ahead, then please click subscribe. And as always, there's plenty of stuff on our website, onmaths.com. Just go there and see all of our free resources. Everything we provide is completely free of charge. I hope you have a lovely day, and I'll see you tomorrow.